Assalamu alaikum, dear students. This is our lecture 2. Our topic is informal fallacies. The course title is Logic and Critical Thinking. Course code is PHI 101. This is Mr. Saqib Al-Lahan, lecture Pakistan Studies, Hangover Campus West. Now, coming to the discussion agenda, in this lecture, we will cover the following points. The first point is that what is informal fallacies, then kinds of informal fallacies like fallacies of relevance, fallacies of presumption, fallacies of ambiguity. In this slide, I will discuss that what is informal fallacies. Before going to discuss informal fallacies, it is very necessary to know about that what is fallacy. A fallacy is always occurs when there is error in the reason. When the argument or the premises are not adequate to prove the conclusion. Now, what is informal fallacies? As mentioned in the slide, informal fallacy is that when the content is adequately failed to prove the conclusion. It is something other than proof to defend the argument. An informal fallacy occurs because of an error in the reasoning. Unlike formal fallacies, which are identified through examining the structure of the argument, informal fallacies are identified through analyzing of the content of the premises. In this group of fallacies, the premises fail to provide adequate reasons for believing the truth of the conclusion. Now, example of informal fallacies are: democratic system is good because America is following democratic system. I believe in the Bible because it is the written word of God to his prophets. Obviously, God would not lie to his prophets. These are the examples of informal fallacies. Now, coming to the types of informal fallacies, there are three major types of informal fallacies, that is, fallacies of relevance, fallacies of presumption, and fallacies of ambiguity. Now, coming to the very first type of fallacies, informal fallacies, that is, fallacies of relevance. A fallacy of relevance is one where the argument in which it occurs has premises that are logically irrelevant to the conclusion. Argument may say that when there is no connection between the premises and the conclusion, then fallacies of relevance occurs. Now, in fallacies of relevance, there are several further types like appeal to emotions, appeal to force, missing the point. Coming to the first type, that is appeal to emotions. In daily routine, you have seen that whenever there is a gathering and a politician is going to present his words, he always uses some certain of emotions. For example, he says that I am an honest person, he says that I am a poor man, and blah blah, and that's why you people should vote for me. Now, this is something that appeals your emotion instead of a proper reasoning or a proper argument. Now, when you vote for that purpose, that is meaning that you have committed the fallacy of relevance. The second one is appeal to force. For example, if I ask you that you should give me 500 rupees, if you would not give me that rupees, I will see you alone. This is called appeal to force. That when a person is using force to win an argument instead of legitimate or proper argumentation. This is called appeal to force. Missing the point, in this fallacy, a person disconnecting the premises and the conclusion, like there is no relevancy between the premises and the conclusion. This fallacy is also known as the fallacy of irrelevant conclusion or mistaken reputation. An example of this fallacy is that there are more reports of theft reported in Islamabad. More people are moving to Islamabad. Therefore, more thefts are caused by more people moving to Islamabad. Now, coming to the second type of this fallacy is that fallacies of presumption. The fallacies of presumption occurs when too much is assumed in the premises of an argument. As a result, the conclusion of the premises results primarily on the basis of the pre-assumed or unwarranted assumptions. There are three types of these fallacies of presumption. The first one is fallacy of accident. In fallacy of accident, when a person presuming too much in the premises, that is called fallacy of accident. For example, killing is wrong, mercy killing is a type of killing, therefore mercy killing is wrong. Now, if you see that killing is something else, while mercy killing is a different case. Now here, mercy killing has been counted in the category of killing, which is a very specific scenario or a specific case. The second one is fallacy of complex question. In this fallacy, a person presupposing the truth of proposition. For example, have you stopped cheating in the exam? Have you stopped smoking? Now, in such cases, even when you are not cheating in the exam, when a person asks you, have you stopped cheating in the exam, it means that you have cheated sometimes in the examination, or you are cheating now in the examination, despite of the fact that you have never cheated in the examination. Similarly, the case with smoking, that you have never smoked, but when a person asks you in a way that have you stopped smoking, it means that you have smoking in the past or you are smoking now. So, in such fallacy, a complex question is asked by the interviewer or by someone, and that question basically presupposes the truth of the proposition. The third one is the fallacy of begging the question. And this fallacy occurs when the conclusion is already drawn in one of the premises. For example, men are better drivers than women because men have better control of cars than women on roads. In this example, you see that the conclusion has been already drawn that men are better drivers. So a better driver has already a good grip and a good control over car and roads. This is called the fallacy of begging the question. Now, coming to the third type of fallacy, that is fallacy of ambiguity. The fallacy of ambiguity is always occurs when there is a word or a phrase used in a premises which conveys double meaning or having double sense, like bad people should be put in jail. Babar is a bad boy, therefore he should also be put in jail. Now here, what bad people means is ambiguous. Example 2, it is said that we have a good understanding of our universe, therefore we know exactly how it began and exactly when. Now here, the good understanding is basically a better understanding, because a good understanding never convey the meaning what the conclusion conveys.